You'll have to drive the 911 Turbo S to believe what it is.
It can scare the socks out of anybody, even the most experienced driver.
I have not been able to exploit the limit of the car.
Turbo for me is ek gear niche, aka Mumbai piche. It's so fast.
I've been a motoring journalist for a good 20 years, apart from a short while where I went to work for a car company. To my mind, Ferrari and Porsche, these are the two greatest car companies. And when the opportunity came about to work for Porsche, I jumped at the chance. These are the cars, that's the cars that have built that reputation for the brand. And in particular, the 911 Turbo, that's what they call the all-weather supercar. Weather like this, you're not going to take out a Ferrari, you're not going to take out a Lamborghini, but you will take out the 911 Turbo. And if you own a 911 Turbo, you are an enthusiast to a fault. Today, we have four enthusiasts and their turbos. These are their stories.
It's a mind-blowing car. Of course, I could not push the car on the Marine Drive, but I mean, the car obeyed my instructions. It's like a point and shoot. Unlike the other cars which I have driven, which are of course sedans or sleepers, this was a phenomenal car from the moment I sat in it. I was expecting too much of it and it delivered. Once I bought the car, I did not wait for it because the car was in not so great condition. So I immediately got it painted, primed up the car, whatever was needed to be done, and then I drove it around. Of course, it had enough power to shame a lot of sleepers. But still not satisfied with that power, I slowly started upgrading the turbo. First I upgraded the tune, then the turbo with another tune. And then I decided still it's not enough. So ultimately then I decided to do up the engine and the gearbox both together. See, the engine was done by ES Motors of Turkey. So before the engine was done, it was pushing about 700. At the crank, now it's doing about 1,000 at the crank. It is too much. It depends where you are driving it. On streets and on freeways, it's too overpowering. But on the track, it's a joy to drive. It's a great car to have. It's got the analog feel, the original mechanical steering, unlike the new gen electrical assisted steering. The gearbox is Triptronic, so it's not a very sterile gearbox. It's, you know, it gives you that whiplash when you want it.
My name is Mohinuddin Motiwala, and this happens to be my 8th Porsche, my 5th 911, and my 3rd Turbo. So first, when I bought a turbo, I didn't know what it is. By then, I'd already sold it. The second time, I bought a turbo because I realized what it is because of the whole Mesger engine, 997.1. I'd already read about it and I wanted to buy a Mesger engine. And 1.5-2 years of me using the car, I got a really good offer, so I sold the car. And then, ever since then, I always had this craving to get a turbo again. Every teenager has bedroom posters, you know. So it wasn't one of the Baywatch models for me. It was a 930 Turbo, 1975 930 Turbo. I still remember blue color. And that's the car I used to look at every day when I woke up and every night before sleeping. In fact, even today my kid's room has a life picture taken at the Le Mans 24 hours of only 911 Turbos. Back in the days, you know, when turbos didn't have SRS, ABS, PASM, PCM, all those safety features, at that time, I agree, they were very, very powerful and they would go out of control. Today, they have electronics, so they are now no more called widowmakers, but the people who know me will relate to this statement. They're called marriage breakers now. So turbo for me is a five-letter word. You can speak a lot about this T-U-R-B-O. It's an emotion. It's a way of life. It's a stress buster. It's, you know, some people may call it a hobby. Some people may call it a status symbol. So turbo has many, many meanings. So it depends on who looks at it in what manner. It's my ultimate bonding time with my family. I always bond with my family in my car. I mean, of course, there's a house, but you know, since I have boys, there's certain things that, you know, they just want to speak to their dad alone. And when they're in a car, they're in a good mood. When they're in a car like this, they're in a good mood. I'm in a good mood. So this car helps us in a lot of father-son bonding. Not that we don't, but you know, this gives us that extra trump card. So this car specifically, if you ask me, I like the small size because it's a 997. It's got the current engine that the 3.8 Turbo S of today's time has, with a PDK dual clutch gearbox. So the earlier turbo with Tiptronic, the gear shift was very, very slow. So this has the latest tech, latest mech, with the actual size of a Porsche. So what happens is a smaller car is easier in handling, easier in maneuverability. It's very, very agile. And because of the short wheelbase compared to the new 991 and 992, I think this car, more than a rear engine, feels like a mid-engine car. So, you know, when you're driving that car, it makes a very big difference in the handling.
I'm Siddharth Desai, and this is my 991.1 Turbo S. Porsche gives me a sense of, you know, like it's an everyday supercar. And that was exactly what I was looking for when I wanted to go from my M3, which is a four-door, to a two-door. It's the amalgamation of everything in one car. It's got practicality, it's got the sense of, you know, wow when you look at it. It's got a heritage, it's got lineage, you know, it's got everything. There's no other car, at least for me, which has everything put together in one car and rides so comfortable. Plus, we live in Mumbai. The roads, we all know how they are. You know, you need a car which you can actually use, and they don't need to be a garage queen. They need to be a car which is driven, and driven all the time. We've driven from Mumbai to Ambi Valley in the worst of rains, even when we were shooting on the airstrip. But the car was steady. The car stays, if you point it in one direction, it is going in that direction. It gives you a confidence. We are all, you know, amateur drivers. We are not professional racing drivers that we have the ability to, you know, make the car do what we want. We are more or less hold on to the steering wheel and let's see what happens. And this car is the ultimate for that. So I've tracked it four times now. Four times I took it to BIC, and the fastest that I could achieve on the last time was 2 minutes 3 seconds and 0.9. So 203.989. That was my fastest time that time. Porsche themselves, you know, there is a alternating weight distribution and power distribution that you know, the Porsche has developed into this car, where when you actually need it, there is only 20% or 30% power up front, and the rest goes to the rear wheels. When that happens, you can have your fun. This has always been my dream car. This started when I saw the 964 Turbo. There was a review back in school when I used to be there. I used to collect all these car and driver magazines, world car magazines, you know. And there was this one particular review about the 964 Turbo that caught my fancy. And from that day onwards, even today, I have only two cars that I'll ever buy. It's either a M car or a Porsche. And as things are going forward, I would rather, you know, stick to Porsches as many as I can, you know, work hard or to at least get or achieve. Yeah. For me, I need a turbo in my life. No matter when, where, I always need at least one turbo in my life. My first actual performance car was a M3, F80 M3. And that actually scared me a lot because of the power delivery and stuff. And when I actually drove the 991.1 Turbo S, that was a completely different beast. So yeah, it scared the life out of me. I think I bought it in somewhere in the middle of the year, and in 2-3 months I took it to BIC for my first track day. And that was my first experience, you know, actually with the power delivery, with the kind of handling that I've only read about. I'd never driven a Porsche prior to this. My first driving experience of a Porsche was a 991 Turbo S. Believe me, there is nothing lacking. Every generation upgrades and every generation becomes better in every aspect. My generation for me is perfect.
My name is Adish Shetty. I drive the 991 1.2 Turbo S. Well, it's a flagship model, and in my opinion, well, it'd be wrong to say that it's the best, because I believe all the 911s are great in its own class. But 911 Turbo S being one of the fastest, brutal acceleration, better handling than most of the other 911s that I've driven. And this is the first Porsche that I've owned. And before that, I used to consider it as a Beetle, to be very honest. And I was not really happy with the way Porsche looks, because over the years, it's always looked the same. Nothing has actually, well, the design is fantastic now that I own it, but it never appealed to me. But like they say, you know, you have to drive a Porsche to know what it is. And after driving it, I eat my words. Well, it's a fantastic car. It's fast as hell. Is very fast, brutal acceleration, and fantastic handling, great cornering, and fantastic brakes as well. Well, this is the fastest I've ever been. With the launch control, it is insane, is the word, if I may use. And I think this would probably be one of the fastest cars in India today. So on the track, we are very lucky to have a fast car in India, and to be able to drive on a airstrip like that. I have a Lamborghini Gallardo. It's an LP550-2. It's a rear wheel drive car, and this is an all wheel drive car. So there's a great amount of difference when it comes to handling, cornering, even the speed. With this, I'm able to push this car even in the rains. With the rear wheel drive cars, it's a death wish if you try to do it. If there's an upgrade from this turbo, it would be the 992 Turbo S. That's the only upgrade that I can think of as of now. It's the new king in the market. The Turbo S runs on ceramic brakes, large caliper ceramic brakes, which makes a lot of difference in the car as compared to the other 911s. So that's the main part of it handling a fantastic braking.
It's everything for me. I mean, that emotion, I just can't put into words. You know, it's a car which I've always wanted, and it just you know, it makes me feel special. Yeah.
You'll have to drive the 911 Turbo S to believe what it is. It's fantastic engineering, great handling, and one of the fastest accelerating cars that I've ever driven or ever been on.
I think it's one of the best cars that that money can buy. If you're looking out for something that's aesthetically beautiful, reliability, at the same time maintenance-free, at the same time performance-built, I think it's like a one-stop shop.
Phenomenal car, a joy to drive. It's a true de-stressor. The moment I sit in the car and start it, crank it, and go for a drive, I forget everything else.
Subscribe to the Evo India channel and hit the bell icon to keep pace with the thrill of driving.